The cross-cutting concepts are seven big ideas that are used in many science disciplines. These seven ideas are powerful because they explain phenomena throughout science and can be used to solve problems in engineering. The cross-cutting concepts are one of the three dimensions of the next generation science standards. They are thinking tools for doing science. In this video, you will learn how to describe each of the seven cross-cutting concepts and use a graphic organizer to show the relationships among the seven cross-cutting concepts. This graphic organizer shows one way to think about the cross-cutting concepts. We will go through the graphic organizer and describe each one. We will also explain what the arrow means. Systems and system models is the most foundational cross-cutting concept. All things that scientists study are part of systems. A system is an organized group of related objects or components. Scientists use system models to understand how systems work. The other cross-cutting concepts describe what patterns happen and explain why patterns happen in systems. Understanding systems is very important in science. For example, a kalo plant is a system that has many parts. This system model of the kalo helps us understand how it functions and predict its behavior. One of the first steps in science is noticing patterns. Patterns help us organize and classify things. Patterns help us describe what is going on in systems. Kalo has a pattern called a life cycle. We can use the pattern to classify a kalo plant by a life cycle stage. Patterns also lead to questions about relationships and causes. Some cause and effect relationships are simple. An effect can have a single cause. Other effects may have multiple causes, or causes may have multiple effects. A major activity of science is figuring out what causes things to happen and how things happen. Noticing the life cycle pattern might make us ask what causes the kalo to grow faster. We might wonder about what causes the life cycle to be longer or what causes the corm to get bigger. The cross-cutting concepts of patterns and cause and effect help us describe what is happening in a system and understand why something is happening in a system. A pattern between two quantities may be evidence of a cause and effect relationship, or it may not. Scientists conduct tests to figure out which patterns are cause and effect relationships. You may have heard the word scale used in different contexts. In daily life, a scale is what you weigh yourself on in the bathroom. In science, scale means something different. Scale is the size of something. Scale varies. Things can be very small, like a cell, or very large, like a solar system. Scientists need to think about scale because scale affects how things work. Proportion and quantity help scientists describe scale. Scientists use scale, proportion, and quantity to describe patterns. Systems can be in a state of stability or change. Scientists look for patterns of change in systems. They want to understand what causes change. Over its life cycle, kalo changes in a predictable pattern. Scientists use stability and change to describe patterns. Energy and matter can explain why a pattern happens. The total amount of energy and matter does not change. Tracing matter and energy helps us understand why things happen. We can trace the movement of matter in and out of systems like the kalo plant. We can describe how energy from the sun is used by the kalo and how the kalo is a source of energy for animals. Structure and function can explain why a pattern happens. Structure can be an arrangement of parts that are put together. Structure can also be the form or shape of something. The structure of things is related to how they function. Structure and function relationships help us understand why systems work. The kalo plant has an overall structure that is made up of many parts. Each part of the kalo plant has its own structure that is related to what it does. For example, the long narrow hulu hulu, or roots, help the kalo stay anchored in the ground and provide a way to take in water. Scientists use these two cross-cutting concepts, energy and matter, and structure and function, to explain why systems work. In this video, we described each of the seven cross-cutting concepts. Can you describe them in your own words? We also used the graphic organizer to show how the cross-cutting concepts are related. Can you explain the relationships in your own words? System models describe what happens in a system and why. Patterns describe what happens. Two cross-cutting concepts describe patterns. Scale, proportion and quantity, stability and change. Cause and effect relationships explain why it happens. Two cross-cutting concepts explain cause and effect. Energy and matter, structure and function. Patterns lead to investigations of cause and effect.